So, Paul, no wait, serious question. When are we gonna hang out?
I probably wouldn't hang out with you because you're...
gay?
Because you're...
Hashtag Team Nikori?
Either a little bit crazy or whatever it is.
That's not friendship.
I don't understand.
Sorry. And welcome to a very special Big Brother 18 post-season show with the person who we all know should have been the winner, Paul! Now, if you guys want to see any of our past episodes back with the other juror members or pre-jury, they're all at yourrealityrecaps.com/BB18. Of course, we're covering Big Brother Over the Top right now. You can check out all of that at yourrealityrecaps.com/BBOTT. 24/7 live feed updates for Over the Top is at BBOTT live feed. Live feeds on Twitter. And if you don't have the feeds, get them through us at yourrealityrecaps.com/feeds. If you guys are watching this in iTunes, 5-star rating and a nice review, YouTube thumbs up and subscribe is a great way to help support our shows. And lastly, become a patron. It's what keeps our shows up and running. You get weekly patron-only shows, prize giveaways to patrons, access to the patron Facebook group, or if perhaps you came in second on a reality show and won a lot of money, you could do a one-time donation at yourrealityrecaps.com/PayPal. With that said, let's bring up the person you all want to hear from. It's da-da-da-da! Paul!
Oh, what up?
Friendship, Paul.
So much friendship. I might look and sound like I'm dead, but that's because I haven't slept ever, so...
You have not slept since the show.
But, I mean, kind of, but not really.
What are you... What are you sleeping, Paul? Do you sleep in your dead skull shirts?
100%.
Really?
Yes.
That is not how I recall it.
That's why it sucks sleeping in the Big Brother house, because I couldn't be naked. I have to be mindful of the bajillion cameras that are around me all the time. I'm surprised there are no... There probably are weird screenshots of me, but...
I don't have to look.
Polly and Corey, so...
True. Oh, my God. Well, I feel bad for them. Look, here's why I was bringing it up, Paul. The number one fan on this show is going to win one of your Dead Skull shirts.
That's what's up.
Signed by you, Paul. So, you guys, right now, it's currently you, a Pam BB fanatic, so way to go. And I also should have said, Paul, we also have a little rocker.
That's awesome.
Rubber ducky for you, too. And I'm sure you're getting a million of them, Paul, but we also have Pablo for you. But I'm pretty sure everyone in America is probably sending you Pablos.
I'm down. I'm down for infinity, Pablos. Fuck it.
They are not easy to come by, so you should appreciate them.
I will.
You should definitely appreciate them. Now, Paul, I don't really know that it has anything to do with you being tired. I think you might be suffering from post-traumatic stress disorder from being out of the Big Brother house.
Literally, 100%.
So I shouldn't do stuff like this.
No, I will vomit on myself. Don't do that.
We don't want any security code red breaches happening on this show. Then, Paul, and for everybody watching, you guys know the deal. This show really isn't about me. It's about getting your questions to your favorite Paul. So I'm going to start firing away at you, Paul, from all of your fans right now. First up... is Allison at XOXO Feedsters, who has a very serious question for you, Paul.
How serious?
She would like to know when we are all getting a formal apology for you naming it your alliance with Paul, PP, and making us all have to say PP, 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 PP all summer as adults.
So funny. Very funny. I will not apologize because PP was the funniest thing ever because PP, it's fucking hilarious. But I'm glad you all said it a ton of times and felt stupid because I felt stupid naming it and being a part of it too. So I guess we're even now.
I refused to say it. I refused to say it. I just said, Paul and Paul. I wouldn't do it.
Yeah, but see, it just doesn't work like PP does. PP's just, it's smooth.
Oh, it is. But, you know, it also makes you sound a little pedophile-y. Makes me sound pee-pee? A little petty. Yeah, it does me when I'm an adult and I'm on Twitter and I'm like, oh, has anyone seen a pee-pee today? What pee-pee up to? No. Mm-mm, Paul. I don't like that. I don't like that. But I'm glad. I'm glad that it brought you
enjoyment. It made me laugh, so.
Good. No, of course it made us laugh. How are things going with the other half of pee-pee, you and Paulie?
I don't know. I don't know where he is. I haven't really talked to him.
So. I hear he's with Corey.
He's out somewhere. He's probably with Corey and Zakiya. I wouldn't.
That's what I hear. All right.
I wouldn't imagine him being anywhere else, so.
Uh-oh. Well, we'll get more into that later. Here's a question from Juju Namaste, who, by the way, loves you. She sent in a ton of questions, and everyone makes sure that I say she loves you. Love you too, bud. If you could align with any past Big Brother player in an all-star season, who would it be?
Honestly, probably Evil Dick, because he sounds like he's down to be crazy. So I think it would be a good alliance. He won. So he won by being crazy. I lost by being crazy. So I feel like that's a solid combination.
We want better for you, Paul.
Better than Evil Dick?
Yeah. A better human, I mean.
Well, I mean, human is different than game player.
True. That's true. He might make you even... Yeah, you know what? All right. In that aspect, great. Chain yourself to him. It will probably actually help. Yeah. Because he'll make you look so... He will make you look like an angel sent down from
heaven.
Yeah,
he'll be a bigger target.
Mm-hmm.
So...
But do you really want to be chained to a bigger target?
I mean, I did it with Victor. He was a competition beast. There was no hiding it. He loved to brag about how much better he was than everyone else. So,
true.
I mean, the guy, you can't deny it. So, he was a competition beast.
Victor.
Yes.
Yes, 100. Oh, we all love it. You and Victor, I don't know if you're aware of this, you and Victor are the reason most of us kept watching.
That's awesome. That's insane. I would have never imagined that, but...
Let's talk about the final two for a second. Redheaded Michelle wants to know, if it would have come down to James and Nicole in the final two, who would you have voted for?
Ooh, that's a good question.
It's one of your top questions. You got that like a ton of times.
That's a fucking good answer.
Would it help you out if I talk like this? Paul, will you vote for me? Paul.
It would not. Honestly, depending on what happened, for example, are you trying to make me cry? I don't understand.
Sorry. I'm not used to you guys being able to see. Normally you guys don't get to see, but now we fixed it.
I don't know. It depends. Like if Nicole had won both those final competitions, like she won that one that plays through there and the, balance, the justice comp.
Right.
I would have probably voted for Nicole.
You would have.
Yeah.
Were you surprised that James voted for you?
I don't know that I would say I'm surprised, because what he asked me and what I answered him as far as the question was accurate, and he knows that. So James is a game player, and I respect him for that, is that he does not play the game emotionally. Although he wasn't a showman's, but he is a game player, and I respect him in the sense that he tossed me a vote because he thought I deserved it, and he sets emotions aside. So that's kind of cool,
right?
But yeah, I mean, I guess Nicole and my game were similar in the sense that we won comps when we needed to, and yada yada, but For my personal Big Brother, respect goes to people who just really, really, really play the game. Like, put your heart into it, put your sweat into it. Be right. Upfront, be crazy. That a lot's a winner in my eyes.
So,
but that's just me. So, I mean, the crazier you are, the more balls you play with.
So yeah. I know we had a lot of opinions watching, but so you, as someone in the game, I know this might actually be not a great happy question to answer, but so are you saying you do feel like Nicole played hard in this BB18?
Yeah, I don't think she didn't play hard. Do I think she played harder than me? No. I think she played hard nonetheless. The girl busted her ass and won a good amount of comps. So
Have you, this is another huge question that you're asked a ton of times, have you watched any of the episodes or any of the live feeds yet?
I've watched just little clips that you guys keep sending me. They are fucking hilarious. I can't believe half of the things that I said in the house.
Mm-hmm.
I just watch like funny little clips, but I haven't actually sat down to watch an episode through and through or like anything more than 2 minutes on the live feeds. But I do want to do a live stream where I watch those three. I think a lot of people said the episode where Polly was crying or Polly was evicted. And then when Victor comes back, and there was another episode, I'll pick three of them. I'll do a live watch and commentary thing. I just need to figure it out and figure out some time when to do it.
When you do it, then I would like to, you can just send me a video message. Although you'll come back on, Paul, I want to ask you the question again after you've watched a little bit, if you feel Nicole played the game.
Okay, sounds good. I wasn't watching, so I don't know.
We were watching, and I would say, I don't know if it's one of your three episodes, but you need to watch your montage episodes when you were Secret Service. Some of the best moments of the season was
really?
You Secret.
How fuck boring was the season if my bullshit Secret Service was the most entertaining?
Well, you know.
I mean, like, they did just eat food and sit in bed a lot, but...
Like I said, thank God for people like you, like Victor. You guys were always putting on a show. It is something that the people that didn't send questions for you wanted me to make sure that I let you know. You made it so entertaining for feed viewers, for everybody. You were always putting on a show and entertaining all of us. So
that's
everyone
awesome.
Appreciates
well,
that.
I'm glad I could entertain you guys.
Now, this question's coming through, which I don't even know why, but would you really have taken Victor to the final two?
Fuck yeah, I would have.
Of course you
would. Fuck yeah, I would. I probably would have lost next to Victor too, but literally friendship. I'm not a dickhead. I'm not going to be teaming up with someone the whole game and both of us helping each other win. Mm-hmm. And then in the end just screw someone over for money. No, I would never do that.
Speaking of Paulie, lots of people in the chat room, I'm Sick and Twisted, most currently wants to know, did anyone send you the video yet of Paulie peeing
pissing in the jacuzzi?
Yes.
Fucking bizarre. I don't know why. I don't know. I didn't know he was taking a piss. I didn't know people still pissed in jacuzzis. I have never pissed in a jacuzzi, so I can't tell you what it's like, but...
And
I don't know why. I don't get it, but sure.
Tons of people, Sherry Blackberry in the chat room right now. A lot of people also, and we'll get into this in a little bit, want me to tell you, Solving Paris, Finding the Hidden Room, another one of the best. All the best moments are tied to you, Paul.
Dude, that was bullshit because A, I figured it out very fast. I figured it out probably 10 minutes before I actually went in. More than that, I was just trying to send everyone away from there. But people screwed it up by talking so much, and I was told that I couldn't lie about anything in the room.
Right.
So that's why I had to come out and do what I did, because I was specifically told, hey, you can't lie about anything in the room. So I was pretty much forced to tell everybody that there's more things in the room.
Right.
But it worked out in my best interest because I had the fucking round trip ticket. So
now
that was pretty crazy.
Have you gotten your box yet from Big Brother with all your...
No, I have not. Not yet.
I think you could probably do a ton for charity putting that round trip ticket on eBay. I know that you do a lot for a charity to help people. See, Paul, when this season started off and we did a trash draft, we watched the videos and Paul was trying to come off like a big D-hay. But no, Paul, we saw through it. We knew that you were a good person.
I was a D-hay.
You were
not
it, in your like K-Frog interviews and in everything, you were like, screw this game, I don't need these people, I'm gonna go and cut throats and screw everybody and death and rock and roll. I don't remember, but I just remember thinking you were like, I don't give a shit, I'll split anybody's throats and I'll curse people out and spit in their face. And it was like, no, we weren't buying it.
I like it. I mean, yeah. I don't know how to explain it. Like, I'm a shit show. I don't know.
Well, here's what you can explain, Paul. Another very serious question from RJ Mitchell, who was one of your biggest fans all season as well.
That's friendship, RJ Mitchell. That is friendship.
Well, let's see if you think so when you hear a question. Who in the cast is and is not invited to your Halloween party?
Ooh. Everyone is invited to my Halloween party. Will everybody show up? Probably not. But I can say that I could definitely see Victor, Bridget, Bronte, Glenn. Who else? Who else would show up? I could definitely see them showing up. Nicole seemed to be very excited about it, so who knows? She might show up. And I think that's, I don't know.
She's got enough money. She can fly there. No problem.
She definitely has enough money to fly out here. So
Meech wants to come. And we just had her on the other day. She said she wants to dress up as her comic book character.
Amazing.
For your party.
She doesn't have to dress up. She just needs to start fucking crying.
Well, I don't know if you really can get on her for that, Paul, because while she might have been the crybaby,
I cried like a bitch.
You were the motor mouth.
Oh, yeah.
What did you think of Zingbot zinging you as...
Hilarious. Amazing.
Really?
Yeah, I saw... I mean, at that point, I knew. I knew there was an ongoing thing about me just not shutting the fuck up ever, so... Which is true, but a lot of people who meet me in real life say, oh, like, you're really chill. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, yeah, I was in the Big Brother house. I had to be a little crazy, but I'm not always crazy.
I'm almost afraid to have the chat room answer this question all at once and break the chat room, but I don't feel like when the Zingbot went after you for that you didn't shut up. I didn't feel that about you at all. I didn't get the tweet. I didn't get his insult towards you. I didn't feel that it was very accurate. So that's why I was wondering if you thought...
Wait, really?
Really, I didn't feel you were a motor mouth in the house, but then again, you hear how fast I talk.
Well, the live feeds, I talk a lot.
Yeah, but still, I think it's just because I talk a lot too, so maybe it just seems normal to me.
Fuck it, talking is good.
Yeah.
I heard nobody else did any talking in the season. I heard they were all just kind of boring and quiet.
Well, we're going to make this show positive. Ed Rizzo wants to know, or first wants to let you know, thanks for being one of the highlights of the season and keeping it real throughout. Many fans agree that this cast was hard to like. Besides people like you, Victor, and Glenn. So, will you keep in touch with anybody else from your season, or... are you kind of done with all of them? Now, in your backyard interviews with Jeff, you were kind of like, I don't need to be nice to these people anymore, and I'm only going to talk to who I want to talk to.
Yes. So. Pretty much so. Like, all right, it's cool that we all shared this experience together, but at the same time, I was forced to share this experience with you, so I don't have to force myself to hang out with you if I don't like you. Like, yeah, this is great. Like, it's like that one... fucking aunt that you never see ever. It's like, yeah, you're my aunt, that's cool, but do I really give a shit? No. So that's kind of what it'll be like. Like, I'll be nice to everybody, of course, but at the same time, I probably wouldn't hang out with you because you're either a little bit crazy or whatever it is. But to sum up that question, I definitely keep in touch with past house guests and whoever doesn't make an effort.
I never cared.
Never fucking cared, literally.
I just appreciate that you gave me a soundbite saying I would never hang out with you that I can use in the mashup at the beginning of this show. When I'll go, hi, Paul, I'm your biggest fan. And then I'll cut it to you saying, I'll never hang out with you. Thank you. Awesome. DJ, who is a fan from the UK, has to jump through a lot of loops to watch this show.
That's friendship, DJ. A lot of illegal loops. I'm into it.
Mm-hmm. He wants to know, did you realize that the jury was going to be so emotional with their voting?
Yes and no. I thought they were going to be emotional, which is why I didn't take James, because I knew that they probably didn't like me a lot more than they didn't like James, because realistically, James never did anything to anyone. Like, he didn't call anyone out. He didn't ruffle any feathers. He just existed. So in my head, since I knew that there was an emotional jury, I didn't want to take someone who had not ruffled any feathers to the final two, because I ruffled all the fucking feathers, so it wouldn't make sense. The other person who I thought ruffled feathers was Nicole, because people just didn't like her. So I was like, all right, well, I have better odds against someone that people didn't like than someone that they didn't not like, you know, went up against me. And with my statistics in the game and my wins and everything that I did, I thought I would have won against Nicole specifically because we were both not liked for some reason. So I was like, all right, well, we're both not liked, but they're going to give it to the person who did more,
right?
I assumed. But that's not what happened, which is why I solely believe that even if I took James up, I would have lost there too. So
yeah, there was a time when I thought you would have won going against James, but then hearing people's backyard interviews on finale night,
it doesn't seem
like you could have won either way, which was... I honestly, by the way, you owe me lots of money. I lost every bet. We were on Twitter. We were like, no way. Nicole can eat a dick. She's never winning. Da-da-da-da-da. I'll bet anybody. And we all were like, there, your final two speech, Paul, another thing that tons of people are making sure that I tell you. Your final two speech, probably one of the top three in Big Brother history.
Wow, really?
Yeah.
That's what's up.
It was.
Holy shit.
People love it. Everyone wants you to know they loved your speech. I want to get... Let's get a little emotional for a minute.
Here we go.
Wesley in the chat room wants to know, Paul, you're like a very... You're very in-depth or very in tune with your feelings. And you seem to be like a really grounded person. So what are you taking from the experience in the house that you're going to use outside of the house to keep, you know, being Paul?
Well, that's a fucking really good question. I am very in depth with myself. I'm in tune with myself. I know what I like. I know what I don't like. Being in the house was definitely... an experience that I value more than just being on a TV show or being on a reality TV show, because I got to be in an environment that I wouldn't normally ever be in. At what point do you seclude yourself from the outside world for 100 days other than going to prison? Mm-hmm. Which is probably better than the Big Brother house, to be honest.
Probably.
So I had a lot of time to just self-reflect. I had a lot of time to realize what I like about people or what I don't like about people. My confidence definitely went up. I'm actually a super shy person, and not many people know that. And it's hard to believe, I know, because I'm a crazy fuck. But I am a shy person. And, you know, with constant confronting and constant just face-to-face and all that confrontation, whatever, that definitely helped out a lot in the sense that I know which scenarios maybe are worth confronting or which scenarios are worth more to just walk away or to not. But I always feel like I have, well, at least now I feel like I have more of like an upper hand or an understanding of human behavior when I'm out.
Right.
Specifically because I was put in such a, everything was turned to 10. Mm-hmm. So in the real life, it's a lot more mellow. So I feel like I just came from an environment where everything was just at a 10 out of 10 out of 10. And now I could see everything at like a 4. And I'm like, holy shit, wow. Yeah. So, I don't know. I took a lot from this experience. And I don't even know if I understand all the things that have come from it. Because it's still all very new to me and all very crazy. But with each day, I learned that I took something really cool from the house.
You did. Well, now, here's kind of a question along the same lines. Lost and Concruised wants to know, who or what inspired you to create your clothing line?
Honestly, I don't... It's more of like a what inspired me.
Right.
I remember I was like 20, I believe, and I had like a little... I don't know, like a little quarter life crisis or some sort of fucking epiphany. Mm-hmm. And I studied to be, I went to school to be a lawyer pretty much that was the plan ever since I was younger. I was really interested in the legal system and whatnot. And so my whole life I was kind of prepping for that. And then one day I kind of just realized that that's not maybe what I don't know if that's what I want to do. And then, but I'm so far, you know, I've committed so much to my studying, you know, just a epiphany of like, oh, what the fuck am I going to do with the rest of my life? And the ideas of the shirts just came to me. I was modeling for a lot of companies and I just didn't like the quality of the stuff necessarily. And I didn't like the shirts that I was modeling. I was like, you know, why am I putting my image on something that I don't necessarily like?
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, you know what? I would like a shirt that kind of had this or kind of looked like this. And I was like, well, if it doesn't exist, why don't I just make it? Or why don't I just make something that I think people would like because I like it. And if people are following me for like my image or my aesthetic or whatever it is, then they might like it, you know, right. That's what I thought. And then I just gave it a shot and it worked.
And it's your artwork. Is it your artwork?
Yeah.
It is your artwork. That's
amazing. I have an illustrator who I work with because I can't draw that well, but I'll draw like a rough sketch and I kind of just go back and forth with him to make the final product.
I see a lot of people also ask, do you design your own tattoos?
Yes and no. So all my tattoos are obviously my own ideas and creations, but I go to certain artists for certain tattoos. So when I have my appointments, I'll say, hey, so I like your style, or I like kind of the way you do things, the way you tattoo. So this is my idea. Use your artistic interpretation of it. So I'll tell them what I want on it or kind of the idea that I'm going for, but I leave their artistic input open because they're an artist. You know, they're the tattoo artist. They're the professional, and I'm going to them for their artwork, so I might as well let them have fun with it, you know?
I said at the beginning of the season, Paul, the number one thing that we always need here at Your Reality Recaps is t-shirts. So if only I can become friends with a t-shirt designer, this could work out real great.
There you go.
That would be friendship, Paul. Now, here's another question we have from New Jersey Girl, who wants to know, Paul, you really seem to learn the game as you went along and were able to adapt and pick up things that others didn't. How familiar were you with Big Brother before you were cast because you played the game like a seasoned vet?
That's friendship. You know, I was definitely familiar with Big Brother, but I'm not going to say I was a super fan because it was not. Mm-hmm. You know, it's been on when I was younger, just kind of in the house. My parents would watch it a lot. I watched some episodes, but committing to seasons, I had never really committed to too many seasons. I committed to 16 and 15, dabbled on 17. So not a whole like insane amount of Big Brother, but enough to like know what Big Brother is.
Now, we also saw in Big Brother that you upped your cooking skills. I don't know. Well, you have not seen it yet, so I don't know if you're aware of hashtag the Muffin Man. Have you been making any more muffins lately?
No, but I plan on it. I've still been super overwhelmed just out back into the real world, playing a lot of music, drinking a lot of beer, getting all sorts of friendship. So everything's just super overstimulating and insane right now. So I'm just taking it day by day. But I definitely want to cook some fucking muffins, I'll tell you that, if I can remember how to do it.
Nikki Cochran wants to know, Paul, what were you most surprised to learn when you got out of the house? And
that I actually had fans.
Besides that you actually had fans, is there any like current event or I keep Pokemon Go? Oh, you don't even know about Pokemon Go yet?
I heard about Pokemon Go. I heard about Harambe. I heard about Stranger Things. So I got to watch all this shit. Is it true that a second gorilla was fucking killed while I was away because of another child escaping?
I'm sure the chat room will let me know, but you just pushed my button, Paul. Let me let you in on something, and now the chat room is going to kill me. I'm looking to see when to get you your answer. Yes, I'm being told yes, another gorilla was...
Another gorilla? How? How do we fuck up twice in the same thing?
More importantly, I got it. A gorilla's dead. When you watch Stranger Things, Paul, you're going to want to watch episode 1, and then you're going to want to watch the last three. Spare yourself everything in the middle. You're never getting those 5 hours back.
Are you sure? Because you're told to religiously watch Stranger Things by fucking everybody. So.
Me too, Paul. And all I want is the 5 hours in the middle back. You can watch the first episode and the last three, and you got the whole entire story. The middle, pointless.
Pointless. Okay.
Just no. Right. And now the chat room wants to kill me, and I will do my job and say no, they're all telling you to watch all of it and that I'm crazy. But if you have a brain, you don't need to watch the middle 5 hours. Let's go to Becca M43, who wants to know, if Nat and Meech didn't put you on the block, would you have stuck with the Final Five Alliance until the end?
Yes, I would have. Victor and I were loyal as shit to everybody who we made a deal with. We were down all the time, but then they all got fucking paranoid and would stab us in the back, and then we'd escape the situation and then screw them over somehow. So it was a bunch of assholes just using and abusing Victor and I, and we were just honest, and then we just won shit.
I think it was confusing for some people, and I say this as one of your biggest fans and realize it's brilliant gameplay, because there were times earlier when you would move from group to group and pass off information, and there were times without DRs for us that we were not sure, like, where your real loyalty would lie, whether it would be with Frank at that moment or the Guys Alliance or...
All of that. See, I was aware... For example, the Frank thing, that was to blow up Frank and Bridget's game because I already saw that there was heat on them. Mm-hmm. So why not kind of just play with it a little bit and make other people do a bunch of other... I would always fuel fires. So if there was a fire, I would add gasoline and step back and watch. That was my job, is to piss people off enough for them to act on it instead of me acting on it. But if there was a time where I would need them to... have confidence or have faith, then I would do it myself, which is why I would call people out so much all the time, is to show them, like, I'd be like, hey, do you want to know if they're lying? Look how they behave in this situation.
Right.
Boom. Would call them out, would prove my point. That was my strategy when it came to those stuff.
I will also say, you, aside from having a ton of fans, Paul, you also have a ton of Big Brother players who have been supporting you all season long. Some of them in the chat room right now, like Derek.
Oh, shit.
Like Derek, winner of BB 16. Lots of people. But you have a very important question from somebody you might know. Their name's Glenn something or other. They weren't on TV that long, so I don't remember. Just kidding. I love Glenn. Glenn is the best ever. Glenn needs to play again.
He is. Glenn's a sweetheart.
He would like to know, if you beat Corey, how different would the season have been?
If I beat Corey?
Yeah, if you had, I guess, beaten out Corey at some point. If you would have beat Corey for Nicole, would you date Nicole? Maybe he's asking if you would date Nicole.
If I beat Corey, and I beat Corey. What do you mean? I already beat. I know, sent him home.
It's a Glenn question. No, I'm sorry. I'm wrong. He said if he beat Corey. It would also help if I could read. If Glenn beat Corey. Sorry.
What would have happened?
Question was not transmitted to me correctly.
So if Glenn beat Corey, what
would
I do?
How different would the game have been if Glenn...
So fucking different. Nicole would not have been HOH that week. We would have clipped the vets off one by one, and we would have seen what would happen.
Right. I think everybody...
I told you guys you got to clip the vets. I was stuck with two of them, and then how the fuck do we go from 12 newbies and four vets to one newbie and two vets? We fucked up. Should have gotten rid of them. Nobody listened to me.
I don't remember, maybe Glenn remembers what it was. It was the wall endurance. Glenn and I were actually watching that together in New York City with other people. And that's what we were talking about. He was like, we said we were going to get rid of those damn vets and we foiled our plans. But he really wanted to work with you and Victor long term.
Yeah, we got friendships right off the bat. Everybody was being weird. We were just getting wasted and talking about rock and roll. I don't know.
Having Glenn really is the best. I think Glenn needs to go back on a second chance this season. Dan wants to know, Dan 1574, thoughts now on Tiffany?
I don't know. She didn't really try to keep in touch with me, so I never cared. I don't know. I'm sure she's a cool girl. I didn't mind Tiffany in the house. She was very intelligent, but a little psycho.
How are you and Bronte?
We're great. I don't know. Bronte thought I hated her, too. I was like, what the hell? I didn't hate you. I tossed a fucking veto for you. So,
yeah,
we're cool. We're talking. We hang out. She's. I was actually supposed to see her this week, but I think she got busy.
Okay, good. Because Bronte was on the show a few times during the season and said she was said she was upset that she heard things. And I said, Bronte, it doesn't matter.
No.
By Christmas, you guys.
I thought Bronte was great, but good. I don't know. I mean, I talk shit left and right, but if people don't get my jokes, then...
Here's the thing, and I don't mean specifically Bronte. I think it takes some people longer than other people to realize it was a game, and what happened in the game stays in the game. It doesn't really matter in real life.
Oh, yeah, everyone's a pussy. They just start crying about everything. I'm sure everybody's holding on to all sorts of... Like, dude, get over it. It's a... Even in the house, they would react like children. Like, if something wouldn't go their way. It's a fucking game. Who cares? You have a 1 in 16 chance and you're probably not going to win. That was my mentality the whole time. And guess what? I didn't win and I'm not sad because I didn't promise myself a fucking illusion of winning when I know the odds are stacked against me.
Right. Here's a good question. Chat room wants to know, fuck, marry, kill.
Fuck, marry, kill. Oh, my favorite game.
Michelle.
Jesus Christ.
Frank.
Oh, God.
And Devon.
Fuck, marry, kill.
Yep.
Fuck Michelle. Kill Frank. Marry Devon.
Yeah. I would go with killing Frank too. I might want to live forever. Like, I might want to live for... Well, I don't want to have sex with any woman, so I don't know. Maybe I have to pick Frank to marry whoever. I don't know. let's go to another question from UTSA. Jennifer, who says, going back to her original question, was there something that you learned outside of the game now that you're out of the game, did you learn something that happened in the game that shocked you? Like, was there anything that you...
Yeah, people boning the amount of times that they bone. What the fuck? Had no idea. People are just fucking left and right, and I'm sitting in a corner patting people down as they're boning at night. I had no idea. Mm. Except for when Paulie told the world on that he was boning Zakiya. But to the they were really... All of them were just... Fuck it.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, I don't know how... I don't even know how they pulled that shit off because I can't even sleep in the bumper car, let alone fuck in the bumper car or any of the other beds, honestly.
And that was only once. There were other people that, like, made it a sport. whatever. Allison wants to know, are there other countries that other countries have done a twist where two people had to play as one house guest? Now, I know that you said Evil Dick, but if you could not pick Evil Dick and you could not pick Victor, is there someone that you would want to be chained to play as one person? Meaning you're not on a team, you play as one unit, and if either one of you get nominated, you both go out. Anybody who you would want to go through the game like that with?
That's a good question. It would have to be someone who is the polar opposite of me. Like, we can't be any kind similar, so...
Meg Malley. Do you know Meg from last season?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
I like Meg. I just was thinking polar opposite. I could see it being Meg, but not really. You're both way too nice of people. You need someone a little more... You need an Amanda Zuckerman.
Maybe an Amanda Zuckerman, yeah.
You needed an Amanda.
You get what I'm saying, right? Like something.
Yeah.
Because if, yeah, it has to be to get that solid balance.
Right.
The equilibrium.
Rachel at Rachel wants to know, are you down with OTT? And if so, who would, or if so, how do you like it? So OTT, Big Brother, Over the Top, which of course you left your polls friendship tips for, is, I mean, I know you just got out of the house, but is that something that you think that you'll check in with from time to time?
I didn't mind it. I watched a little bit of it, and I want to come back when the house guests have kind of set into their skin, per se, because I can kind of still see a lot of either trying to be something too much or not, or holding back a little bit. So I don't really want to see the house guests come into their shells because I don't give a shit. So once they're all comfortable and start swinging is when I'll start watching. Hopefully there is people who are going to be swinging. I know Jason's a little bit loud, but I can't imagine how much farther he's going to make it if he keeps...
Yeah, well, the problem is he's not being loud enough, I think, to the right people. I mean, Jason, you will love. Jason loved you. Jason and I had many conversations about you before he disappeared and stopped talking to me. And I was like, that's dicky. And then he popped up on Big Brother. But he loved you. He was a huge Paul fan. AIW27 wants to know, how were you able to, and how long did it take you to come up with some of your brilliant strategic moves, such as, and this was the highlight for me on the season, your fake fight with Victor to get
guys
Korea.
Like that? You like that?
I believed it.
Dude, it was this close to fucking working. This close.
It was.
We had Natalie on board. We had Michelle on board. And James was on the fucking fence. If he didn't have that Texas friendship shit with Corey, it would have worked. Mm-hmm. And it would have been the craziest shit ever. Stuff like that is very on the. It just happens as I go. But like I put stuff together because Victor was like, you know, they're starting. They really have a distaste for you. Mm-hmm. And in my head, I'm like, okay, so how can we? I know that they're gonna vote Victor out. I know. What is the only way that they wouldn't? And in my head is like, well, if they see that we turn on each other, then they'd be like, okay, well, we can get them to take each other out. Paul wants to get Victor out. Victor wants to get Paul out. They're both strong as fuck. Why don't they just, we'd let them kill each other? And it almost worked, mm-hmm. but it didn't. But Victor came back in anyway, so.
Many, many times, which is why we all loved Victor. Speaking of things we love, I'm going to speak for, I think, a lot of the women in the chat room. Definitely a bunch that watched all season, as well as the gays, Paul. We all have a very serious question for you. And it's, when are you shaving the dead animal off of your face?
The dead animal. Just mean as fuck. No, I don't know when I'm bored of it. I'm not bored of it yet. It's friendship.
I have to say, I think it really, I don't particularly like beards. They scare me. But, I mean, I know, I'm a hypocrite. I just use it to hide double chin.
Has a scruff.
I'm hiding my double chin. That's it. Otherwise, I wouldn't have it. But no, I remember your pictures were everywhere. Your side by sides, and everybody was like, get Paul. They loved you without the beard. Loved you without the beard. But look at, Kenny from Big Brother Canada. You can make a lot of money with the beard. Plus, it's very on brand for you.
I appreciate it. I think it fits my image, but I'll take it off when I'm bored. I want to get my neck tattooed eventually, so.
I'll allow you to keep it, Paul. I'll allow you. It's okay. You're allowed to keep it. So many people, I think this is the craziest question ever, although now it's your number one question from the chat room right now, which is making me almost scared to ask it. Would you play again Beth D and Whitney, both most recently want to know?
Yes, I would. I can't promise that I'll go far because it's going to be hard to, I mean, it'll be interesting. But what I would have to bank on is house guests who would want to play with me or who would want to team up with me. It would definitely be – I mean, I definitely would do better because I would have more experience. Cough, cough, being a vet mm-hmm. definitely fucking gives you the upper hand.
Right.
But yeah, I would totally do it again. I would have a fucking blast and I would try to scare the shit out of all the house guests. I don't know.
The other half of the chat room, I am really turning these people against me between the TA Stranger Things and now your beard. Okay, nobody wants you to save the beard. Apparently, I'm the only one that wants you to save the beard. I apologize. I even brought up the word beard. I apologize, chat room. I apologize. Brooke D wants to know, what do you think about the conspiracy theory about your French fries, which I hope you know, because I don't.
Funniest fucking thing I've ever heard in my life.
Okay, what is it? How do I not know?
So, I make French fries because, I don't know, I just fucking make fries. You cut up the goddamn potato and you toss them in oil.
Right.
And I made fries. And apparently they were so, and I don't know how to do anything in the kitchen. Like, you can ask my mom. I'm useless. I don't know how to work an oven. Not anymore. Now I'm a goddamn pro. Mm-hmm. But before Big Brother, I was fucking garbage. So, I made fries once and they came out really good. And then I was like, oh, this is cool. Let me add this next time. So every time I made it, they just got better and better and better. And they called me out for lying because my fries were so good that they're like, there's no way he's never cooked before. He's lying about his fries. I don't even think he's 23. He's probably like a 30-year-old who owns a restaurant. My mom is dying because she knows that I can't do anything. And these people are conspiring that I fucking am a chef. It was really funny.
The chat room is telling me there was a lot of hashtags during the season of Frygate and Who Lies About Fries were popular. Hashtags apparently this season.
I wish someone put me on the block and said, Paul, I'm putting you on the block because your fries are so fucking good. There's no way you're not a chef. That would have been hilarious.
Yeah. Have you seen hashtag not gay Corey yet? Which I'm allowed to say because he made a shirt about it.
He did make a shirt about it. I have seen it. It's very funny.
It's very funny. Zendia supporter wants to know, do you still think that Natalie is a CEO millionaire?
No.
No.
I do not think that.
Do not say anything bad about Natalie. I will let you know. Don't. Simply because no, you didn't. I'm just letting you know. We're having Natalie on probably Monday. I'm getting death threat emails. People like, if you ask her one bad question, if you say one bad thing about her, we will find out where you live. I'm like, oh, whoa, okay. People are
amazing.
They're crazy protective about Natalie.
Natalie's fans?
I guess.
Yeah. People randomly just spam me saying shit like, oh, Paul was just trying to break Natalie and James apart all season. It's like, in what world was I ever trying to do that? Hilarious. Her fans are funny. But yeah. I think my fans are funny. My fans are fucking hilarious. Make me laugh. All I do is look at my Twitter and just shit my pants because my fans are the funniest fucking people ever.
You need to look at the Cheeto video. I don't know if you've seen it yet. Like, yes, we did something with it, but I'm sure a lot of people did it. One of my favorite mashups that we did this season was in the middle of the Paulie and Natalie and everybody screaming at each other fight. And you're just like
Cheetos
quietly taking the Cheeto out. And you're like, I don't want to make a lot of noise.
Because I didn't want any part of that fucking conversation at all.
Yeah, Alex Loves You says, do you plan on buying a bunch of Pablos and giving them out to fans? I have a feeling you're going to get a million Pablos to give out. You could probably give them right back.
What I wanted to do was get a ton of Pablos and sign them, mm-hmm. and then go to like a children's hospital or something, and maybe if there were any kids that were fans, give them to them,
right?
Or maybe sign a few Pablos and like get a some sort of auction and then just donate it to local like children charities or like non-kill animal shelters. I basically work with a lot of homeless and non-kill animal shelters or charities, really. But anything, I mean, something like that I want to do, but I don't know if I'm going to get a bunch of Pablos just to fucking get a bunch of Pablos, but if I have any extra ones, I'm setting up a lot of meet and greets. I don't mind signing shit for people. So if you have a Pablo, I'll sign the fuck out of it.
Well, make sure you let us know if you start doing things with that, because we do, we love to support charity and do stuff for charity. So we'll do anything we can do to support that and get the word out for you on that. Also, speaking of pets, because, well, you own a cat and I think cats are from the devil, but I'm a huge dog lover.
I have three dogs.
I know you do. And people also are like, tell him to tweet more pictures of his cat. But here's the important question from Sparkly Eye, wants to know, since you love animals so much, when are you going to start making dead skull apparel for dogs? One that says hashtag pissed would be perfect for my boy.
I actually was thinking of doing that before I even came on Big Brother. So way to jump into my brain.
Mm-hmm.
But soon, bud, there's a lot. First, I wanted to bang out all those fucking friendship shirts because I know everybody was asking and going crazy. So I was like, all right, these people want it. Let me hook them up. Let me do something fun. So I'm dealing with that right now. And some of the hats and the friendship shirts, I'm basically this month they're going to be available. I know a lot of it's sold out right now, but that's because they're sold out and I need to ship out this batch before I do it again, because I don't want there to be issues, or I don't want it to take forever. So I'd rather do it slowly but not fuck orders up than just go ham, you know? So once I'm done with these shirts, I'll move forward and do like some dog stuff, because I've wanted to do that. I was actually going to release a dog shirt exclusively for donating it to a non-kill shelter, but I didn't have time to do that yet. But it's coming.
Good, because I want one of those, and I do love that. And I know a lot of people want to know, are you doing sitting duck shirts, too? Another
I'm not, because I'll be honest, I want to start moving forward with more Dead Skull Apparel stuff that's not Big Brother related, because Big Brother has nothing to do with my company.
Smart idea.
But I will make, you know, the three shirts that I made, those are for you guys. It's a little memoir for me too, and I love designing them. But after that, I kind of just need to go back to what I do and not so much Big Brother stuff. But I think, I don't know, maybe Victor will release the same duck shirt. Who knows?
On a complete side note, a lot of people are saying when you watch Big Brother Over the Top, check out specifically Shelby. A lot of people feel
that she went to Pepperdine University as well for law school. And she's a fucking babe, so
they're saying they think that you two would be a good couple. So they're telling you.
Yeah, I mean, she's definitely very attractive. So.
Spring Curls wants to know, Paul, what was your secret to staying so humble in that house amongst the other house guests?
I like to think that I'm humble inside and outside of the Big Brother house. I've definitely experienced a lot of things in life that have shown me to kind of stay level-headed and stay grounded and always be thankful and humble for what you have or what you do.
Mm-hmm.
I just don't like the latter. I don't like the other personality. When people are not humble, when people are kind of just show-offy and stick things in your face and just act like a fucking asshole, I don't think that's cool. So that's the last thing that I want to be. I never want to be – the way that I look at those people – I don't ever want to be looked at that way. So I make an effort to not be that kind of person, because I just don't have respect for it myself. So
A lot of people want to know, Vanessa Caprio most recently wants to know, would you ever do Amazing Race?
Yes, with Victor. I think that'll be awesome. I love traveling a lot. Like, traveling is my fucking jam.
Mm-hmm.
So I think if Victor and I teamed up to do something like Amazing Race, we would actually make a really good team. Between how well we do in competitions and, I don't know, my traveling experience and his map reading shit skills, I think it would be fucking great.
Note Text wants to know, why did you lie to the other house guests about your one vote to keep Victor? I think most would have been okay, considering it was a sympathy vote. And P.S., despite how I started this sentence, I love you. Hashtag friendship.
Shits on me and then loves me, but it's cool. Good question, but there was actually strategy behind it. So, I'm not a dick. I was going to toss Victor the sympathy vote because he was my friend in the beginning and it was sad and everybody turned against him and I wasn't going to be the one person to turn my back against him when everybody else did. I stayed true to my guns like I did the whole show as far as where my loyalty stood. But I wanted to toss a wrench in the mix because at that point I knew that I was probably next. So in order to potentially save myself, which I did, mm-hmm. I had to cause some sort of drama. And what better way to cause drama than to vote the other way, deny that I ever did it, and make blame it on somebody else. Michelle and Frank got so much shit that week because people thought it was them. And then Frank became the next target. So I think what I did had a lot to do with it because people just pointed Frank out as a liar. And I think he took some heat for that as well when it was my doing the whole time. So it was just strategy because I knew I was probably next.
Right.
Just wanted to start some shit.
I know in when we started this show, you said, Michelle come to the Halloween party and Michelle love, and I'm not sensing any not love between you and Meech, but one of the moments from the season, which the chat room insists we talk about, is when she stole your poor Pablo. What was that like? For you.
It was shitty. What the fuck, Big Meech? Why would you do that? I don't know.
She has apologized, by the way.
She better apologize. She has a pop. People probably send her Pablo death threats for taking Pablo. I don't know. Pablos. Michelle's crazy. We were the crazy ones. I wouldn't expect anything less from Michelle. Let's put it that way. To grab Pablo and throw him into the crowd, but I mean, I don't care. But. I mean, it sucks. I don't know where the fuck Pablo is. Let's talk about that because everybody keeps... I don't know where he is. I don't know. Apparently, he was in the crowd on finale night. I don't know where he is. Production's probably going to send me a box with him in it. I hope. But who knows? He might make a fucking cameo appearance on BB Over the Top. I don't know.
If you want a giraffe or a zebra or one other one, we kept trying to buy Pablos to give away to people. They just kept sending us every other animal.
Yeah, because apparently they're sold out everywhere, these Pablos.
Yeah, I wonder who made that happen. how long, Radicarly42 wants to know, how long did it take you to get the pink and glitter out of your beard from the exploding potion memory competition?
That comp fucking sucked. And it hurt when it blew up, by the way. It fucking didn't feel good. And it was all up in my ears and my nose holes. It sucked. It took a while. It took a few beard shampoos to get all that shit out. It was terrible. I hated it. Mm.
Zappa 2001 in the chat room wants to know, Eric, with lots of exclamation points, ask Paul about the 30 times he was crushing on Bridget. All of us Paul Idgit fans really wanted that one to work out.
Yeah, Bridget's a babe. I don't know. I definitely, there's no denying that I was crushing on her, but, I don't know. We're friends. Me and Bridget hang out. We hung out a few times since we've been out. She's cool.
Oh, good.
Bridget's fun.
She's the only one who, I don't know, who I can't get to cut on the show. So call your buddy after this.
I'll text her.
Tell her to get on here. Paul, there are, Allison wants to know, are there any house guests that you really didn't connect with in the house that you wish you would have tried more or made an alliance with?
No. No, I don't wish any of that. I'm glad I didn't make an alliance with over half of those people. Hmm. And I'm glad I didn't connect with the people I didn't connect with because I probably would have been evicted if I did. So... No, I'm very much so sticking to my guns with I am proud of every single move that I made and everything that I did. I would not change. So
good. Yeah. BB Hyde wants to know, which one of your three jobs is your favorite? Clothing line, music, or modeling?
Interesting question. I don't know, man. I don't really see like the question itself already threw me off because I don't see any of those as jobs because I love doing them. Like, they're all really fun. They're all me being creative. Like, modeling is an outlet for creativity because I get to put on an image or act of, you know, a style or whatever it is I'm modeling for. And same with music. It's me being creative. Same with my clothing company. It's me being creative. So all of these are just outlets for my creativity. they're not work at all because I love doing it. Like, I don't consider, I act like I don't have a job because I don't, it doesn't feel like I'm working when I'm doing any of this. It just feels like I'm having a good time.
Which is why we need to say, just like this for me, we only have about 10 minutes left, everybody, with Paul. Time is flying, Paul.
It's definitely flying.
I'm going to try and get through some of these questions.
How many people are watching?
Oh, 2000-ish live.
That's friendship.
They love you.
Mucho friendship.
Has Paul heard... Oh, no. Well, actually, I'll ask this. Sick and Twisted wants to know, have you heard of Chrissy, the girl from Big Brother Over the Top? Have you heard of her band, Evil Engine?
No. Is it good?
I don't know.
Evil Engine?
The Little Engine? No. Evil Engine. It's evil. It's a bad engine.
I'll check it out.
Okay, yeah. It doesn't seem like it's for me. Tess McLean wants to know, oh God, do you know that Nicole and Corey made it way past first base? It wasn't just canoodling.
I found that out outside of the house, and I don't know how I feel about that. Definitely weird.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely weird.
Juju Namaste wants to know, if there is one thing you could change about your game, what would it be?
I wouldn't change anything about my game. I'm telling you guys, you could ask me this question 1,000 more times. Ain't changing it. Would not change anything that I did because I think I did everything I would have done in any scenario. So,
all right, sorry. Here is a very serious question for you from Bigzilla in the chat room. And she says, Paul, will you be the sixth Backstreet Boy? They're looking for a new one. Mucho love.
Are they really? Because AJ from the Backstreet Boys apparently was my biggest fan. Super cool guy. Oh, yeah. He was at the rap party.
Oh, no. I think you mean the other one, the blonde one.
No, not
me. No, you mean AJ? AJ, how do you know more about the Backstreet Boys than me?
Because I fucking love the Backstreet Boys.
That's because you're young.
I'm a 90s baby. The Backstreet Boys were the fucking jams.
Right. I was New Kids on the Block.
That's what's up.
Joey McIntyre. Yep. We already did that. Okay. How shocked were you? How shocked were you to find out how many fans you have now that you're outside of the house? But no, not just, oh, I'm surprised. For really real, Paul, tell us for real, how surprised were you? Lots of exclamation points.
Oh, shit inside of my pants. I guess you do understand because you were watching the live feeds. When I tell you I thought everyone hated me, I thought everybody hated me. The first question I asked when I came out, it was my mom, my dad, my family, whatever, the psychologist, security guards. I was like, hi, I lost. I know, I get it. It's fine. It's a game. Never cared. How much does everybody hate me? And they're just like, what are you talking about? I'm like, do people hate me? I'm an asshole. What is it? Like, what is the general? Am I going to get, what is happening? And they're like, no, people really like you. I'm like, wait, really? And they're like, yeah. I'm like, are you sure? And then it wasn't until I had to walk out in the rap party and was like bombarded with people and even my interviews, people are like, you know, you're trending on Twitter right now. I'm like, what the fuck? Are you guys serious?
Mm-hmm.
So it's still overwhelming. When people come up to me on the street and they're like, oh my God, like they're so excited to see me. I'm like, holy shit. What's up, man? Super overwhelming. But I mean, it's good overwhelming, but I definitely didn't expect it.
Right. Giselle BB17 is letting me know that also I was thinking of Lance Bass, who was also a huge fan of you.
See, that's in sync, dude.
Right. All right. Whatever.
You gotta get your boy bands right. Come on.
Boy bands. I wasn't asking this because I don't know the people who are asking it, but now that I see someone that I know would not have me ask a question that we could get in trouble for, I will ask it. It's from Christy Sturck and wants to know, what is the Berlin story?
Oh, God. We don't have time for that. That's like a 30. That's a long story.
All right, well, then, oops, you're going to have to come back. There you go. To be continued.
I'm going to have to come
one.
Back. You guys got to tune in for the Berlin story. Let's just say it's a good story.
All right. Let's just say it's a good story. All right. So then let's do this, Paul. people want to know, for starters, where can they see you? We know that you're going to do something in Canada with Victor. So
Let me give you the low. I'm giving you the rundown. Okay. First of all, I'm doing everything that I can to set up these meet and greets. Mm-hmm. Victor and I plan to do them mostly together because it's friendship. We're trying to, right now we have the Edmonton, and I believe we're doing it at a mall in Edmonton as well, so that it's all ages. Right. And then I think we're doing Calgary and Vancouver, Canada. I know Vancouver for sure, 100% Vancouver is coming up as well, shortly after Edmonton. I think we're working on Calgary and Toronto and whatnot. So as far as Canada, that's what's happening. As far as America, I'm working on it. I definitely want to set up a few dates in LA, because that's my hometown, obviously. And we'll definitely be doing one in New Orleans, because that's where Victor's from. New Orleans, whatever the hell, however the fuck you say it. We're doing that. And then I think I will be coming to Texas as well. It's just a matter of, I don't necessarily know what I'm doing.
Right.
And I want to find places that are not going to charge the people who are coming to see us. I know a few places have like just tickets and drinks and stuff that you just need entrance. Mm-hmm. But I'm trying to sort out venues that, or places that I can do this legally without them charging people.
So. Well, I will say this. The chat room going crazy. The places I see the most, if this helps you at all, I see lots of Ohio's, lots of Chicago's, lots of New York's.
Okay, let me write this down.
Chicago, Ohio, New York, and I can help you with me. Well, I mean, if you want to stay in our house, you're welcome. But here's what I will say for you for New York. Adam Pock from Big Brother 12 100% has fan events all the time with house guests where nobody has to pay. And I'm sure if you end up doing anything in New York, he could help you with that out very easily.
All right, amazing. So, all right, I made note of Ohio, Chicago, and New York. I'm going to try to get all these done. If you guys have, this will help me out.
Go ahead. You want to be, I can tell you a lot more places if you want be your poll.
Find places that are down, like maybe a bar or a restaurant or whatever, and have them email me and I'll fucking just do it like that. The easier you make it, the more so I'll just fucking show up somewhere.
Let me help you out here, because I've gone through this route before. Here's what you should do, Paul. You should create a Gmail account.
I have one.
No. A separate Gmail account when you want people to help you out with stuff like this. Otherwise, it's going to flood. Do you not think you're going to get 1,000 emails now from people telling you, like, my sister's house, my cousin's house down the block?
Well, not your fucking sister's house, but you know what I'm saying.
Oh, no, they don't, Paul, trust me.
Well,
death threats about Natalie.
Death threats about Natalie.
You should have created a fake email. No, but people, you heard them. I will put below this video, of course, we'll tweet out anything that Paul is doing. We'll try and help you guys out to have that information. We're live every day doing shows, so when we see where Paul's going to be, we'll update you guys with that. Where can they follow you on social media, though, Paul, that they can, follow all right. What you're doing?
Instagram at DeadSkull, Snapchat at DeadSkullSnaps. Mm-hmm. Twitter at DeadSkullTweets. And that's about it. I think that's all the social media that I have. And then DeadSkullApparel. So DeadSkullApparel. DeadSkullApparel.com or at DeadSkullApparel on Instagram.
Okay, perfect. So two more things, and I'm giving you full screen for this one, Paul. Obviously, full screen. You have thousands and thousands and thousands of people in this chat. We couldn't even get to all the questions, and they kind of broke the chat too. But amazing. What do you want to say to all of your fans watching Paul?
Wow, way to just put me on the spot. Mm-hmm. All my fools, because I think that's what I'm calling you guys, right? My fools. You guys are fucking awesome, A. B, I literally will marry all of you at the same time. So if you guys are down, we could arrange this group marriage. Thank you for supporting me. Thank you for being there. I love all your fan mail. When I tell you I sit down and read every single one of them, I do, and I am going to answer every single one of them. But if you don't get an answer back immediately, just hang the fuck on, because there's a ton of them and I'm doing my best to get through all of it. But really though, I appreciate it. The artwork, the writing, the little gifts that you're sending, they are all make my day so much more better. You guys are creative and hilarious and amazing. Just thanks. Like, thanks for, I don't know, like, thanks for supporting me when I thought that I had none of it. So it's really nice. It's a good feeling.
You had so much support. Half the chat room is like, where is this wedding? I'm going to be there. I'm concerned for some people, because I legitimately think some people don't know that things are jokes. But everybody loves you so much, Paul. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
If you want to give a shout out to your number one fan on this show, it's Pam, BB Fanatic, who's getting your signed Dead Skull shirt.
Pam? What up, Pam? I'm going to sign that shirt all over the place and write friendship a billion times. Are you sure you want me to sign the shirt? Is it going to ruin it? I don't know.
Well, believe me, they want you to sign the shirt, Paul.
Okay, I don't know, dude. Garbage signature, nobody wants it.
They want it, believe me. They all want it. And we all want to hear that Berlin story. So apparently, Paul is going to have to come back again after things have settled down and he has done his world win tour. Or whenever you want, Paul. You are always welcome back. I know we would love to have you on a recap show, or people would just love to hear more from you wherever.
Yeah, I'm down. Time and place, and we'll have a fucking reality recap friendship chat.
Oh, we totally should. Another thing we didn't even get to, because we're so over our time. But yeah, your friendship chats were up there with Nature Watch, which I know is Victor, but you made the show for everyone. I just am speaking on behalf of all fans when they say we love you, Paul.
Thank you, guys.
We will see you guys all later. Follow Paul on all social media. The links will be below this video. We will see you guys later. Bye, everybody.
Later.
Hey, just kidding. I love you.